Doing okay? Doing all right? I haven't seen you in a long time.
You better believe that. Long time.
Everything's alright though.
Yeah man, most things. Most things, not everything.
Right.
I lost my wife 4 years ago, you know.
Oh really?
Yeah man. The 15th of this month was the 4 years.
Wow. Sorry.
Yeah, yeah. One of them things. She had cancer, I know.
Okay.
Put up a 7-year fight with cancer and lost. She had it real bad, so.
Okay. Spread
No, but it's too low. You want to go up on the hill? Yeah. At least he's in the full of dirt. Muffler full of dirt.
Vincent.
You need to come up on the bump, Vincent. You need to come up on the bump.
That can't go. Lock your door, Vincent. You have to sink the front of the car to get up the back of the car. Come back, Vincent. Come back with the car.
Ask now.
Back ice now. That is, all right, sir. All right, you're mad.
You must have been out there. You drive, right?
Yeah.
Could you go with this guy and get on shovel, sir? Please, thank you.
So, intermission from the grave digging because somebody broke a shovel and had to go take somebody to go get two more shovels. And yeah, you can't break up the earth with the shovel, with an old shovel. You have to actually separate the dirt, loosen it up with the pickaxe or a fork, and then shovel out the dirt. That's the update. Working on the sound system. We have drinks, food, some liquor early in the morning. It's actually only 10 a.m. or 10:20, and yeah, we're working on it. So I'm gonna go pull some dirt out of the grave so I can say I helped dig the grave, and I'll see you guys later.
Every 2 hours,
I give more than 1 6 rum
to you. Thank you.
Yeah.
Chill.
You ready?
I'm not going to go. I'm not going to get it. I'm going to go.
Just take a couple of minutes.
Okay.
Us in there. So hold on, let me see. No. When we go inside, I'm going to. So make sure you get me, Gio, Mark,
whoever else comes over.
Whoever.
You recorded already? It's already recording, right?
Yeah, it's recording now.
It can go in water.
The
other day he threw his in the in the beach. We're at the beach, I just threw it in the water.
Me no, I put my one in there.
But you have to be careful because if it gets a crack, that's why I got a new one.
Okay, John.
I don't put mine in the water. But like, let's say I'm sitting like by the pool or something. I don't mind if my hands are wet. But I'm not gonna put it.
Your man. You know what you spend. You have your account to you for what you need to use.
Exactly. This is a little my TV, computer, phone, camera, everything.
Okay.
Yes. It just gets dark, but it keeps recording.
That look nice.
It's a No, I was saying that about my phone.
You know your phone have everything.
Yeah, this is a GoPro, I think. My brother's thing. It's like you could wear it in the water.
How are you, mother? Well, at least you might try. You might try.
You're welcome.
Cause I don't want my boy to be loving me now.
That is the one on the rim of my cup, not on this side.
I still didn't tell you. Okay, I'll get the plan then.
Picture of the look, man. You cannot take me picture on authorized.
No.
No, I'm recording the road. Just a reminder.
This is your neighbor.
You know, I never got in an accident with that car. And then New Year's Day, Simone, me, Shannon were going to some bar or something. And then all of a sudden somebody ran
Simone
in my back.
Simone, Haitian girl, eh?
No, the black girl. Simone, the black. She's not Haitian. She's Jamaican.
Simone, yeah.
Simone, the Haitian girl was Tamar.
Tamar.
Remember Tamar?
Yeah. Shit, man.
I'm going to get a fair party,
but
they don't work. She got married now.
Two kids.
Yes. Yeah. Over, I think it's over 100 miles an hour. It's careless driving, reckless.
Yeah.
But it's up to the police officer to decide. So he gave me a ticket. But he really gave me a blight because the ticket was, it should have been a reckless driving based on the speed. Because I was dead asleep on a highway just sleeping.
And then you look at what, you know what, Chevy.
Yo, Mark, remember that trip, man? What's one? Forget the one, it's going on.
This one, I'll share you the thing.
So apparently a dog fell in the grave and we're gonna go try and get it out. You got him? No, you have to.
Wait, my hands go by neck.
Watch it.
You're coming this way?
Oh, go on, so to Courtney.
You got a rope, you know, tell a rope or a piece of cord. I just tie it around his leg quickly and bring him up and then release him. You know what I mean?
Oh, hear his foot? Hear his leg or something?
No, he just fell in here.
So give him the ladder. And the board, let him climb up the board, drop the board in there.
You can't risk the material, you know.
Oh, you have another board. There's two of them.
I told him, but you have another one material, CMR, Sipsan. But we don't have any narrow piece of board. Well, I'm not from the other.
All right. Okay. The log and the bricks. Yeah, and the ladder. The log, the bricks, and the ladder. So, here, 6 feet, and the bucket. So yeah, this.
Here you go. Check it.
No, it's not time to eat now.
Not time to eat now.
Okay.
We're gonna put a lot of bricks down here. Somebody gonna find a piece of board. Hold on, let him come. That's easier than a hold it for bricks.
So let him walk on the ladder.
Time.
Oh.
Huh? Lean the ladder this way. This way. This way. Long ways.
Huh? Yeah, I don't think...
Lean the ladder long way.
No, I don't think he's going to do that. But you never know. If you have a piece of, I was saying if you have a piece of board to put it this way.
Right, okay. Yes, and there's one here.
There was a slim piece of
board. You know, watch your step because around the grave is a hole there.
Yeah.
All around. Yeah. And this... board.
Is that wide enough?
Very wide. No, it's 4 feet, but we can make up the difference. Oh.
That's one. Put the light on it. In the middle.
Come on.
One more pull.
Look here now. Put this over by neck.
Yeah.
Come back the long board outside.
Yeah,
when you put your way and get 20 where are you?
Well, pull it up.
Fast, you have to do it fast.
Alright, release it now. Stop it, boy. What was I holding?
Start around his neck, stop around.
What's in my... You can't get to that pussy.
Come on, get ready.
Alright, now. So wait, you need that brick on him.
Take on the leather. Alright, just cover this up now.
Hold aside down
the drive. Wait a second, put this. One leg
you're going to put in one.
Hold on. Yeah, man, see you.
Watch your wall, that's good.
Fine, what you say? Take out the leather.
Where you are? Don't make it that. You're not naughty. Not really now, pal.
I said,
It's the coverage for the video. So, funeral number 2. Uncle Randy, Ronald Anderson. Funeral is today. And we're getting ready. We're almost ready.
Where are you?
Is the AC on? Yeah.
Whoa, somebody in here again. Come out. Mm-hmm. The butterfly.
Okay, I got him.
You got him out?
Yeah. No, you know, what I'm saying is, I was telling them that the immediate family needs to leave behind the hearse, so we can't be parking in the back behind everybody. Anyway, park.
Yeah.
Well, back up.
You can do it in the back.
Go ahead. Yeah. Go ahead. Come, keep coming. Come. And then you should be good there.
Okay.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right.
Can I come over here?
Yep, just park it there. Yes.
Alright.
And look, he's parking right in the middle in the way. I told him. Is he? Yeah, we shouldn't have come back here.
I'm back here, right?
Well, we're just riding in the bus. We're just riding the bus and leave the cars here. Online.
No, today you're looking
for. Oh. They were in the trunk of the car. I took them last night.
Okay.
This is, you see? This is not good. And he's over there. He's right there in the pink shirt.
Okay.
Just ask him to.
My love, my sweet, sweet papa, the one out of me showed me what real love is, my dad and uncle Mike. Rest on my sweet, sweetheart. I love you. You're going to love me. Oh.
And acceptable to God Almighty. So please observe the following for me, please. I'm going to be asking that we check and turn off our cell phones or put it on vibration.
Ronnie recalled an incident. What happened?
while coming from school one day. You see, Ronnie rode a bicycle to school. And so that particular day, it's raining. He told me that his mind raced so fast, thinking what to do, because no way he could take his little brother in the rain. Anyway, he said he looked across the road and saw one of his dad's friends. He said he dashed across the road and asked this individual if he could give his brother a lift home, seeing he had to pass the house. But he said that individual turned him down. But somehow he said, the rain is down. And he quickly put Michael on the bicycle and rode home safely. A brother's love indeed. How ironic. When Ronnie got sick, you were the first person I called for help. Ron, you have to come because it was death for life. Ron was taken to the hospital and boy, you have a challenge for you have to help him. And so God, I want to thank you, Michael, for being there for him. I thank you so much. And so his life continues. Ronnie and his brother Michael grew up in the family business, as most of you here presently knew that their father, a well-known farmer in the area. Ronnie had a passion for farming. One fresh in his mind, he took a 6-foot sport at the Quinton Park in Spanish Town. He did home gardening and landscaping, completed his course, and received his certificate. As his two brothers, they worked on together. They formed their own contracting company, R&M Anderson, with Alton Jamaica Company, now called Rodalco. Their job entails maintenance of the entire Pleasant Farm and Hayfield Village, the upkeep of the beautification in and around the Alton's property, bushing of the power line, the roadways from Orangefield right up to Copper Peaks. Doing such a good job at landscaping, Ron was offered a contract at Nestle in Baltimore. And so as the time went by and things changed, the contract with Alton came for them. And so full attention was now given to the farm. Ronnie loved the soil. He tried to send it everything. Such one in peppers, corn, peas, various crop, which I must say were successful. The running of the two farms wasn't easy for Ronnie and Michael. Hyde was the name of the other property, Bobo, which was cultivated in cane. Many obstacles and challenges were a part of the journey. But nevertheless, they never gave up. They continued. Hyde became a history, and so focus was more on the super sun. People from all walks of life, near and far, came to buy sweet oranges. Sometimes the magnitude of customers, Ronnie and Michael, worked late in the night with faithful workers with them. Ronnie did long work and runs, leave home at 7 in the evening, and returned back home in the wee hours of the morning. Always praying to God for protection in him on this long journey. Being with him once, the porter, going down was okay, but the journey back home was so lonely and dark and long, but God got us home safely. Ron was such a devoted man, was always willing to take his customers to anywhere they wanted to go. I remember one incident where he had to deliver oranges for customers at Carnation Market. But unfortunately, there was a disturbance on Spanish Town Road, roadblock. And believe it or not, every single orange bag was taken away. Few told him thanks, then told him that he could go through. They say he was a good man. Each time he remembered it, he would have a good laugh. That didn't dampen his spirit, which was Martin. Was every Friday morning, leave home at 4:30 with Norman. He was no pushover when it came to looking after his family and putting food on the table. Ronnie, a storyteller, no matter the conversation, Ronnie had a story or a joke. Being with such a wonderful and amazing human being for 50 years, and knew him well. As young people met Ronnie for many months. We got married in December 15, 1979, had four wonderful children, took our vows before God and man, and swore in our vows to death to us part. Baptized and accepted Christ in his life in 2000. What we say, he held on to Jesus all the way, challenging, but kept going with Jesus at his side. Ronnie loved church. He loved his church family. Teaching Sunday school, his Joshua generation group. Harvest, he gave his heart. He was always concerned about the maintenance and the upkeep of the sanctuary. He may not have been perfect in everything, but he had a clean and pure heart to man and God. Ron was life itself. Loved God through words, either from the Bible, or when he preached, or when preached by man. Songs and praise wasn't too much for him. Ronnie's ability to make everyone feel comfortable, secure and loved were his greatest strength. Malice and hatred wasn't a part of his life. Humble care and respect to all people of life. Had a few mishaps, but as the minute goes by and a handshake, everything's back in order. The grant, the center of his life, a well-rounded life before age. He beamed when they are with him, the first three grandgirls, the three Zens, Zanae, Sariel, and Zahela. He saw them from basic to prep and then to high. The journey with them has just started, but his words were, if he didn't live to see them achieve their goals, he was thankful for what he saw from them. Anything that entails, your love for Papa was involved in supporting dance movement, babysitting in New Kingston, where they could have fun with their friends. Highlights of his life was when Zaria and Zane gave their life to God and was baptized. He beamed that night, clapping his hands and thanking God. Aubrey, Jaji Jade, Tyler and Keneal were also in the act of his eyes. Thanks to God, he knew them all. Not just know them, but had them in his presence to give Big Papa's love. Aubrey and Kenny, the youngest, hasn't a clue what's happening around them. But in some sense, whenever doors open, Kenny would look and say, Papa come. In a nutshell, Papa was love. Couldn't want a better husband, father, and grandfather than Ronald Anderson. No matter what, for us as a family, he gave his full support. What I loved about Ronnie, and that he was a truly family man. He was involved with other kids that were in the area. Not only just our kids, picking up and taking them to school, PTA meeting, birthday parties, family outings. What was not just for the family, but others in the community. Thank God for technology, because it helped them, so helped him to address those who lived abroad. He wasn't a hostile father. He spoke to them with love, always telling them that whatever pathway they choose in life, it must be pleasing for him and God. To be good citizens, live good, be kind. Help if you can, but most of all, be respected for all. And so in all this, we give our thanks for the privilege to have this warm, caring, kind, and loving soul in our lives. We thank you, God. The many visits that I had from his friends and family and church families gave me the strength to go on. The magnitude of love for Daddy was overwhelmed. It helped me feel so proud when one spoke so highly of one who made an impact in their lives. Young or old, the older he got, the love shines in him, and his faith in God was unmovable. His life here on earth was short to me, but I won't complain. But I just want to thank God for all the years given to him, precious years, which will always be treasured. My friend, my heartbeat, my husband, my storyteller, my everything, the life we spent together, no regrets. I thank you, Lord, for the years we have spent together until you called Ronnie home. We shared so much together, same peacock, same reading glasses. Never a dull moment is treasured enough that we are in our senior years. No matter where we are from any distance, our eyes would somehow make contact and would just smile with each other. A real blank we were. This is not goodbye, but we will see each other again. My darling, sleep well and take your rest. Love you for all eternity.
Never miss you. Never miss
and me life perpetual, shining always. He did all this on earth, not for man, but true to God. His reward didn't come in trophies, citation, with a BA or degree. No, he didn't. Just a humble, loving, and happy soul who became every and mostly best friends to people who came in contact with him. On March 25th, 2019, my dear sweet Ronnie, Daddy, Brother Ronnie, eyes closed and left. And as he takes his final journey, we say, take your rest in the sweet by and by. He leaves to mourn. Mommy, children Michelle, Giovanni, Mark and Charlie, and grandchildren, brother, Owen and Michael, Lockley, Sister Marion, Brian and Sherney, one uncle, and two aunts, sister-in-law, Tom, Raquel and Sonia, and Noah, sharing his partner in politics and truly. Favorite cousins, Austin and Ella, brothers-in-law, father and mother-in-law, cousins and niece and nephews, grandnephews and grandnieces. Friends near and close, near and far, from US, Canada, Mr. Sherman, passport, passion, business associates who had the privilege of being visiting with him, Mr. Julia Phillips, General Home, the patron, all who are here at this Thanksgiving service. This is a testament that Ronald was indeed no shadow of a doubt that the bond and love between you all was solid. Thank you all. May your beautiful soul rest in peace. Thank you.
Amen.
Yeah.
see another side. New Testament is taken from 1 Corinthians chapter 15. Reading from verse 50 to 10, which is verse 15. Now this I say, brethren, that flesh and blood cannot inherit the kingdom of God, neither that corruption inherit incorruption. Behold, I shew you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, last trumpet, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass, saying, that is written. Death is swallowed up with victory. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. For thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as we know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. Amen. Amen.
He showed me again a water bottle. We had a good laugh. Man, I laughed till I was unable to drive comfortably back to down to Jericho. And that was the last time I booked him up at any of those places. Every time I see him, he said, Pastor, me not have a bad company then again. So. But I could tell you much, much more, but I know you soon will be able to get outside. So permit me to share a short little message with you. When Ronnie died, a verse came to my mind. Romans 8 and verse 28. And as hard as I tried, the verse would not go. And I've heard reflection on it at our prayer meeting. And I said, Lord, that is the reason why I must let it go, but the verse still did not go. So I'm going to share. Romans 8, 28. And we know that in all things God works for the good of those who love him, who have been called according to his purpose. Now, this verse is one that sounds very familiar. And many of us as Christians and as believers, we know this verse. But my brothers and sisters, it is one of the most challenging and one of the most difficult verse to come to terms with. When we read God's word and when we reflect upon it, this verse was written by the Apostle Paul to a group of Christians. And there is one writer who is of the view that this verse is the summary of the entire book of Romans. Why? The writer is saying that almost everything that Paul wrote about in the book of Romans can be found associated with this verse. Now, I did not have the time to do all that was necessary to ascertain whether he was accurate. But when you read this verse, my friends, it is obvious. This verse is offering some beautiful instruction. The verse is offering us insight. And the verse is inspiring us on our journey as Christians and as believers, as we would seek to walk with the Lord. It is a verse, I believe, that not everybody will be able to appreciate. But it's a verse that is a part of what God would have us to understand about Him and what He would have us to embrace. And so you think about the verse, all things work together for good to them that love God and to those who are called according to His purpose. What a verse. Whatever I say about this verse today, I don't believe I'll be able to even scratch the surface of what is in it. But for our situation today, I'm going to do just that. Just to make some brief comments. When you read the verse 28, and you come to the verse, the word know, and we know. It seems to me that the writer is crediting us with some knowledge of God. And the writer, who is Paul, is crediting the Christian and the believers and the people of God with some knowledge about the person and the character of and the attributes of Almighty God. And so he made the point, and we know. It seemed to me, church, that as mature believers, when we look at a verse like this, we cannot miss the fact that God is sovereign. That God sits on the circle of the earth. That God determines the affair of every human being. And He is in charge of the movement of history and the movement of your life and my life. God takes counsel from nobody. He is God. He is in charge. And He is in control. So when we think about the fact that our knowledge of God exists, we must understand that it extends to His sovereignty. But if you believe, yes, He's sovereign, then it is not too far to think about His supremacy. Supreme in life. Supreme over human beings. Supreme over the course of your life and my life. Because God is really and truly the one to whom every knee shall bow, the writer declare, and every tongue confess. So church, think about it. Even in life or in death, God is ultimately in control, and He is in charge. We cried. We shed our tears. We mourn. We grieve. Yes. We are cast down, but we must never forget that we are dealing with the God who is in charge. And we simply need to allow Him to be God. Hard to let Ronnie go, but we have no choice. Hard to say farewell to Ronnie, but we have no choice. It's hard to come through the church door and not seeing Ronnie greeting you on a Sunday morning. You know, I don't know how, I mean, God had endowed him with the capacity to deal with everybody from the babies right up to the seniors. He could deal with everybody, and everybody was comfortable around him. And that is the kind of person we like to have around us. But then comes a time when God decided that he had completed his work. He had run his race, and it was time for him to go on to his rest. None of us, my friend, would have anticipated that. But we have to accept the fact that as human beings, we have limitation. We can know so much and know more. We can see so much and know more. Yes, we can understand so much and know more. Because there's a limit to what we are able to do as human beings. And so in our limitation, we could not see that the last Sunday when he came to church and had such a good time, that was his last Sunday here. We really didn't know. And all the fun we had with him, we did not know that that he was nearing the end of his earthly sojourn. I tell you, if we had known, there are so many things we would have done differently. I know that he would have gotten more hugs and more kisses than he had received. He perhaps would have gotten more accolade than we had heaped on the man, because he deserved everything and more. But we just did not know because we are limited. So church, God knows, and God has done his best. You and I have to accept that. But the second thing the writer tells us, it's not only our knowledge, he's not only talking about our knowledge of God in the text, but he's also talking about God's knowledge of us. So we can have a knowledge of God on the one hand, but God is also knowledgeable about each and every one of us. Can I tell somebody today that your life is like an open book, and right now God in his wisdom is turning the pages of your life, and is looking into every crevices and corners of your life, and there is absolutely nothing that he's not aware of. Why? Because God's knowledge of us is sincere. His knowledge of us is significant. His knowledge of us is a comprehensive knowledge. He knows when you and I were born. He has taken us from that point. He has carried us through all that we have been through. And he knows when it will be our final day on earth. He's knowledgeable. And so he's able in the life of the child of God to take the good, and he work it out to our good. He's able to take bad things that happen to us, and he turn it around, and he work it out to our good. Why? Because he is God, and he is in charge. No wonder why the songwriter declared, God move in a mysterious way. His wonders do perform. Because God is God. And when you read it, the writer is declaring, and we know that in all things God works for our good. Lord, help me. What good can it be to have Ronald taken away from us? Really and truly, I don't see it. Family members, what good to know that he's not there with his human again? What good is there when you can't pick up the phone and call him again? What good is there when he'll not be at the graduation or at the recital of his grandchildren? What good? Trust me, I can't see it. You can't see it either. But the writer is declaring that God is at work. And God have a way of bringing everything together for his own good. So what is the verse saying to us? We need to just trust God and live. Surrender our lives to God and live. Because God holds the ultimate power and authority over your life and my life. God is able to work things out for our good. But thirdly and lastly, when I think about this verse, I see that we have a knowledge of God. But and we also see that God is knowledgeable about us. But thirdly, when I look at the verse, it tells me that God knows his purpose for our lives. Church, God knows his purpose for every one of us sitting in this chapel today and outside. God knows! He has a purpose. He has a plan for every one of us. We do not always know God's purpose for our lives. We do not always know his plans for our lives. We do not know so many things. But God knows. And he's working that purpose out. That's why I can say to you, beloved, everybody in this place, courage, my brother or sister, do not stumble. Though your path be dark as night, there is a star to guide the humble, the seem right and the clear. Yeah? Trust in God and do what is right. The writer went on to the song, will love you and some will hate you. Some will slander you and some will even slight you. But the writer said, see some man, look above, trust in God and do what is right. Yes, because God is involved in working his purpose. Oh. My brothers and sisters, when you think about it, you and I, we do not know what tomorrow holds, but God knows. And he's a step ahead of us, working. And he's really and truly preparing the path for us. It is, and so we must always remember that we are only pilgrim and strangers, old time words those, eh? We are simply people passing through, a creature of time and space passing through the universe. And our tenure in this world is supervised by God and God alone. And at the end of it, he is the one that will wrap things up because he is in charge. But he has a purpose and he's working that purpose out. So then, church, if we are knowledgeable about God, and God is knowledgeable about us, and God is working his purpose out, then, can we understand this? We must understand that the greatest experience of a lifetime is to know Jesus as our personal Lord and Savior. The greatest experience of a lifetime is to be to Jesus for the cleanse and power, and to know that you are washed in the blood of the Lamb. The greatest experience of a lifetime is to be born again by the Spirit of God. It is to be converted into a relationship with Jesus. Why? Because this will last not only during time, but we take it with us into eternity. For Romans 8, it is the writer declare, neither height nor depth, neither principalities nor powers, neither things present nor things to come, is able to separate God's people from God's love. So we know that God is working his purpose out. Yes, he's working his purpose out. As painful as it is, family members, accept what God has done. And just celebrate the fact that Ronald was lent to us for a time. He made his mark. And the Lord said, Ronnie, it's time for you to step up higher because you have completed your work. Mark is something, you know. Because it would have been nice if we got some sign that Ronnie was going to be leaving us over a period of time. It would have been nice if we could make our adjustment. But we don't get none of that. The bigger boss just step in and say, Ronnie, your time. What then should I leave you with as we read this verse? All things work together for good. To them that are the call according to God's purpose. Church, Christians, all, there is a call of God that we must ensure that we do not miss. For what Paul was simply saying, and when you look at it very carefully, is that there is a calling of God. Have you answered that call? Have you answered that call? There is a call of God for all of us. It is a call that offers a comprehensive insurance. So when you come into Christ, you are covered in the name of the Father. You are covered in the name of the Son. And you are covered in the name of the Holy Spirit. When you come into a relationship with God, your eternal destiny with God is secure. And nobody can interfere with that. Whether they like you or they don't like you. Whether you have money or not, it doesn't matter. You are wrapped up in Jesus. And your destiny is secure as a believer. And today, I want to appeal to those of us who have not yet made the calling and election sure. Your number will be called one day. My number will be called one day. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? If you are not ready to answer the call of God without any doubt, yes, it's time for you to make a decision today. God is awesome in the business of salvation. God is awesome in the business of sanctification. God is awesome in the business of transformation. God is awesome in the business of securing your soul and my soul in a world such as this. He is awesome. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God. So Ronnie has gone on to rest with his Lord. Ronnie has made his calling and election sure. What about you and I that are left? Our number could be called anytime. So you know the truth about that? We are all lining up down the runway of life. The bad thing about it, I don't know where in the line I am. Whether I'll be the next person or you'll be the next person. So, but we are all lining up. And it's only a matter of time when we have to make our transition. And so the word of God comes to us today. Are you ready to meet your maker? I met a lady recently who told me that Ronnie said to her, "Sister, a long time we know you, a long time we live in the community here. But a time now for you give your life to God. You can't just live so." Then I noticed that she followed his advice. And she gave her life into the hands of God. Church, God has given us the privilege to live. While we are living, it is the moment to make our calling and election sure. That is it. Hello. I know the times in which we are living. Some people don't believe in the Bible again. Some people don't believe in God. Some people don't believe that they need to make a decision. Some people think you can preach them into heaven, or a friend can sing them into heaven. There's all sorts of things happening around us. But I want to say this. Whether you live in London or Paris, whether you live in Toronto or Moscow, whether you live in Havana or Florida, it doesn't matter, to meet God, because we have an appointment with God. And the writer reminds us that it is appointed unto man, and after that the judgment. The call of God is available. Listen, I respond to it. Amen.
I'm going to go ahead and go to the crowd.
Oh, no, bro.
She's right there, auntie?
No.
Who?
I was gonna ride
with
she
was walking.
She
came out.
The road is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the road is called up yonder,
let this be the resolve, let this be the commitment of all of us, that when the roll is called up yonder, surely we'll be there. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'll fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Nor is Christ raised from the dead and has become the first fruit of them that slept. In him all shall be made alive. Friends, we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we'll take nothing out of this world. It is the Lord who gave, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. After labor comes rest, after struggle peace, after this fitful fever, this last sleep.
Please, we're gonna ask his brother wants to see him. But he didn't get a chance to see him. So please make a shift for me, please. No, wait here, wait, right.
Let us continue.
You get a chance? Did you get a chance to see?
For as much as it pleased Almighty God to take away from this life the soul of his son, our loved one Ronald and his son. We like commit his body to the ground, ashes to ashes and dust to dust. May return to our Lord and Maker, in certain hope of the resurrection which is to come, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Invite our silence as Apostle Hilton offers the prayer.
Let us pray. Gracious God, our Father, we come before you this evening, Lord. Many of us with heavy hearts, because we know, Father God, that this separation was not planned. This is not something that we anticipate or can ever be prepared for. But you, in your infinite wisdom, Father God, know the hour and the time. You know every thought, even before we think them. We know, Father God, that you have prepared a place for him. We come now, Father God, in full surety and trusting in your promises that you will receive him into your kingdom. But God, for us that are remaining here, we come now, Father, as you have promised, that you would send a comforter. We ask, Father God, we know it's already here, we just ask you that you would surround all that are mourning on today.
Oh, yes.
All that are grieving, Father God, that you have the ability to comfort. But you said, Father God, in your word, that they that shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty, that you will give them coverage. We come, Father God, trusting in your word that you will, Father God, ease our pain. We know it is not easy. We know it goes with time. Some of us will never forget, and we pray, God, that we don't. But we just trust in you, Father, that you are able to comfort us even in the times when we miss him the most. Father, we just thank you for your goodness. We thank you for your grace. We thank you for your mercy. We thank you for every provision that you have given us, Father, even the strength to endure this hour. We ask, Father God, that you would just wrap us now in your arms and keep us in your care. We commit to you this soul that you might, Lord God, bring you home into your kingdom, because you have greater needs and greater purpose. We know, Father God, that this is not the end. And we know that, Father God, for those of us that believe and have accepted your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, we shall see him again. We just thank you for this opportunity, and we bless your name. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Amen. The vault will be sealed now by the workmen, and I ask also to continue with the lustful singing. I must have the Savior with me, for I dare not walk alone.
I must have the Savior with me, for I dare not alone. I must feel his presence near me, and his arms around me throw.
Then my soul
shall fear no fear.